with the 60s, everything capsized. We were coming out of the Cold War, the 1917 revolution was a thing of the past, and the best minds deemed that mankind had at long last reached maturity, and that the only thing at issue was knowing when and how people were going to achieve a universal standard of civilization.
We're a two-step family now.
Then things collapsed, in Cuba, in China. But if it had to be summed up in one word, that would of course be Vietnam.
Good morning, Vietnam. This is the Dawn Buster.
Okay, we're inbound to the target now. We're down in Farquhar. We'll be approximately about 35 miles south of Canto, down near Camau in the southern Camau Peninsula of South Vietnam. And we're going to make a strike of four Sky Raiders. Each aircraft, we carry normally 6,000 pounds of bombs, and it's absolutely outstanding. Today you will see bombs and napalm, and that two of our aircraft, lead and number two, are carrying bombs. We'll have 500-pound bombs and 250-pound general-purpose bombs, and three and four will have napalm, so it should be fairly exciting. We should see a little ground fire and a lot of napalm burning and maybe even some Victor Charlie.
Beaver 2-3, Bull Moose, over.
Roger, go ahead.
We've had some reconnaissance by Viking down there. We're asking them to go back in and mark specific positions and lines of positions. They've encountered some bunkers about 40 meters south of the river at various places, but we'll try to get them smoke and tell you what it is. Over.
There you go. Okay, follow his bombs.
One, two, and...
Okay, his bomb there, Simcoff. Okay, they should hit now. Okay, look out to the right now. Okay, right down there. Okay, napalm now. There it goes. Ah, look at it burn. Look at it burn.
That was a little short of the tree line, but that's in another tree line, so no problem. Have you got strafe left, Jake?
Roger, make sure the strafe is nice for you.
Roger that. Move on in.
Okay. See, I'm going very low now to avoid the gunfire. Okay. Pull up just short of the tree line. Up we go. That was an outstanding target, all right? We bombed, first of all, and we could see the people running everywhere. It was fantastic. It's very, very seldom that we see Victor Charlie run like that. When they do, we know we got him. If we can keep him on the runway, we know we're going to really hose him down. Okay, we bombed, first of all, and then we beat up the area, and that's when they started to run. Okay, then the napalmers come across, and we strafed immediately in front of them, see, to keep their heads down. We were receiving heavy ground fire. You can see the tracer bullets coming up past us. Fantastic, and we really made them run. That's outstanding, because when they get out of their trenches in the open, we can really hit them, and that's what we like to do. That's what we're here for, and boy, it's outstanding to really catch them out in the open, but we don't do that very often.
Were you dead on target?
Oh, absolutely.
You think you got them?
Oh, didn't we get them? Couldn't you see them run down there? Man, I know we got them. We could, I've got four 20-millimeter cannons you can see out here, and we really hosed them down by Joe. That's great fun. I really like to do that. The Army will go in this afternoon with helicopters and have a look around. They'll probably have to fight their way in because you can't ever get them all out of the bunkers. So it should be fairly exciting. I really wish I could go in on a clearance search immediately after one of our airstrikes, just to see, you know, really how effective they are. They really praise us for these big bombs and the napalm especially. They really like that napalm because when they get there, why, the ones that the napalm hasn't burned up, why, the VC are just addled because of these big bombs. You see, it breaks their eardrums and makes them kind of senseless.
La guerre du Vietnam.